Hello students and welcome back to bankexamstudy.com. So today we are going to do the forward contracts. In previous lecture I taught you the basics of derivative, in which forward contracts was a part. So today we are going to do an in-depth lecture on forward contracts. So let's start. My name is Ramandeep Singh, and what is the basic meaning of the forward contract? So in the previous lecture I already explained you that in forward contract, there is a basic difference between forward contract and future contract. Is the forward contract, in the forward contract, exchanges, the stock exchanges are not involved. Two parties, it can be either a bank or an organization, two parties are involved and they are doing an arrangement themselves. So let's do the basic definition. A forward contract can be defined as an arrangement between a customer. So today I'm going to explain the forward contracts related to currencies or foreign exchange, as foreign exchange forward contracts are the most popular forward contracts, right? So today we are taking currencies or the foreign exchange as our example. So a foreign contract can be defined as an arrangement between a customer and his banker, wherein the customer enters into an arrangement with his banker either to purchase or to sell certain sum of foreign exchanges at a future date. So I already gave you an example in the previous lecture. I gave you an example of the Vardhman woolen mill, right? What do the Vardhman do? They have a unit where they import some cotton. They produce a special kind of wool. They produce a special kind of thread, actually, where they import a kind of cotton, right? Or the sometimes what they do is they export their thread to the international market, and they get their payment in US dollars, right? Sometimes they pay in US dollars, and sometimes, as it is a big company, so they also deal in US dollars. They sell in US dollars and sometimes they buy in US dollars. So for example, today the price of a one US dollar is equal to, I'm giving a rough example, that might not be the correct picture today. For example, the today's $1 is equal to 63 rupees. And suppose the Vardhman made a sale, today they entered into a deal today and they are going to get 1 lakh. I have already explained this example in previous lecture, and they are going to get $1 lakh on on 28th Feb, right? So they are not going to take any risk. What they'll do, they'll go to their bank and they will enter into a forward contract. And their bank, I'll give you a proper example in the next slides. They'll enter into a contract wherein their bank promises to buy the dollars on a specific date at a specific price, right? So let's move forward. The contracts, these forward contracts, are governed by the Foreign Exchange Management Act, the FEMA. So this act is actually amended many times. So what are the features of a forward contract? There are exchange rates. I have already explained you the exchange rate is predetermined, the rate that on which the contract is fixed. For example, this rate, the $63 rate, this is the spot rate. This is spot rate. And the rate at which the bank is going to buy $1 lakh, that is a forward rate. So let's move forward. These are the various parts of the forward contract: the exchange rate, parties to the contract, execution over the. So I'm going to explain one by one now. So what is the exchange rate? Simply as $1. Let's give it a simple example. $1 is equal to 63 rupees. So this is the base currency. So in the agreement, obviously the bank and its customer fixed in advance a rate at which the currency is ex- changed at the future date. So today, for example, it is 3rd Jan, right, 2018. So they decide in advance that on 28th of Feb, at what rate the bank is going to purchase $1. They are going to decide in advance. Maybe today the rate is 63.10. Maybe the bank is going to buy on 28th of Feb, the bank is going to buy at a lower price or at a higher price. That actually depends whether the Indian rupee is available at a discount or at a premium. So this price will be predetermined, right? The rate that a contract at the time of booking will be the rate that will be applied on the due date. So this is all, that's all. This is called the exchange rate. This rate is predetermined. The parties to the agreement, there can be agreement between two banks. There can be agreement between a bank and its customer, right? And further, it can be possible that, for example, I already gave you the example of Vardhman. The bank can either promise to buy the foreign currency at a predetermined price on a particular date. They can promise to buy or they can promise to sell. There can be two type of contract, the two type of forward contract. The buying, there can be a promise to buy at a predetermined price, or there can be a promise to sell at a predetermined price. So a bank can, you know, give a promise. So suppose at 3rd of Jan, the price of US dollar is 63.10. The bank can promise to buy at, like, let's say 63.05. The bank is going to buy at this price. So how the bank gives the quotations, how the prices are determined, I'll give you a proper example after these terms. So execution of contract, for example, I already told you. So in this example, on 3rd of January, right, Jan, both the parties entered into a contract that on 28th of Feb, the Vardhman Woolen Mills, what they will do on 28th of Feb, Vardhman Woolen Mill is going to get $100,000 and they are going to get this money from their customer, from their client, and they will present this currency. They will, in the hard copy, in the physical form, they will get this currency in the physical form or in their accounts, whatever. They will deposit this money on 28th of Feb at a particular time to the bank, right? Or there can be, it can be happened in another way. There can be possibility that the the Vardhman, they may need to buy the machinery on 28th of Feb, right? They need, suppose Vardhman need $1,00,000, $100,000 on 28th of Feb. The bank and the Vardhman Woolen Mills, they can enter into a contract that on 28th of Feb, the Vardhman Woolen Mill, they will buy $100,000 on 28th of Feb at a predetermined price. Right? There can be a buying contract, there can be a selling contract. But there is a promise. No stock exchange is involved, so there is a lot of credit risk that I'm going to explain. The execution of contract, that's how the contract is executed. There is a physical, you know, exchange of foreign currency. So that's how I have explained. Over the counter product, the one most important part that I missed here, the failure on the part of the customer to take the delivery would force the bank to sell the currency in the spot market. So in case the customer who's going to receive, for example, in this example, in case the Vardhman who was going to get $1,00,000 on 28th of Feb, if Vardhman do not present the $1,00,000 in front of bank, if Vardhman they do not bring that much of foreign currency to the bank, then the contract will be breached. Then the bank, they will sell the currency on the spot market. Because see, what do the bank do? The bank is a middleman. The bank is a middleman. And what they will do, they will do some buying for forward contract, and they will do some selling forward contracts. Suppose they will promise to buy the US dollars from Vardhman. Suppose they promise to buy US dollars 1 lakh from one person A, then like let's say 5 lakh to person B, right? And they will sell $6 lakh to some other party, right? But there will be some margin. The bank charges some margin. Even the bank is not taking any risk. Bank is a middleman here. So let's move forward. Execution. So what is the over-the-counter product? As there is no stock exchange involved, so this is a product which is available at the counters of the bank and not at any exchange. So this product is not available at any exchange. I have already told you the bank is involved, and the other parties who promise to buy the currency at a future date, or who promise to sell a particular the foreign currency at a particular date. So what is the advantage in case of stock exchanges? There is a lot size, right? In case of stock exchanges, if you have ever heard, there is a specific standardized lot size. Even in case of gold, in case of US dollars or any other foreign currency, there is a fixed lot size. But in case of banks, they customize their agreement. As the Vardhman, they wanted to sell $1 lakh. Okay, the bank will take $1 lakh. If somebody is looking to sell $10 lakh, they will take $10 lakh. If somebody is looking to sell like $86,666, they'll take it. So it is customized. It is over-the-counter product. There is no standardized lot size. What are the counterparty risks? So, for example, on 28th of Feb, the Vardhman, they do not come to the bank and present their dollars. Then the risk arises. For example, the price of dollar is 60 rupees 63. Price of $1, dollar one. The price of dollar one, US dollar one, is 63 rupees 10 paisa. And the Vardhman was going to get $1 lakh on 28th of Feb. Due to unknown circumstances, the price of dollar on 28th Feb, it went to like, let's say, 65 rupees. It went to price of $1 went to 65 rupees. I know it is very difficult, but let's say it goes to 65 rupees. And Vardhman didn't present this the dollars to the bank. So the bank needs to, the bank who was supposed to get $1 lakh at 63 rupees and 5 paisa, they didn't get it, but they need $1 lakh because they have an arrangement. So they are buying from some people, they are selling to a few people. So what they need to do is they need to buy the dollars from the spot market at 65 rupees per dollar. So they end up making a loss of 1 rupees and 95 paisa, right? Because bank is a middleman. They buy from some people, from some parties, some banks, and they sell. They enter into a buying forward contract and they enter into a sale and a forward contract. So they are a middleman. If there is any kind of risk, if the any party, if any of their client or customer, they refuse to buy or sell, they need to buy or sell, the bank need to buy or sell the foreign currency in the spot market. That is counterparty risk. What is the period? Generally, the forward contracts are available up to 1 year. It is not available for more than 1 year. Normally, it is for like 2, 3, 4 months. So let's take a simple example, students. So that's how the bank provides. This is actually a real example, real life example from 15th of December 27, 2017. I took this example from HDFC. HDFC, this is an example of HDFC Bank, right? The spot price that the bank is offering 64 rupees, that is in US dollar, and the base currency is INR. So these are the three statements. The first statement states that the quote for US dollar against Indian rupee. So if you are going to sell the US dollar to bank right now, today, if you are going, the bank is going to buy the US dollar for 63, 64 rupees and 3 paisa. Right? The bank are going to buy the US dollar for this much money. But if and the bank is going to sell their dollars for 64 rupees and 5 paisa. Are you getting me? Obviously, there is some margin between bid and ask, between the selling price and, you know, buying price. There is some margin so that they can make some money. There are some operational expenses. So what is 1900? What is 2100? Let me tell you one simple thing. These rates are always in 100 pence. So 21 and the 19 mean 19 paisa or 21 paisa, right? So here the quote on the left hand side is a rate being bid or rate at which the quoting bank is willing to purchase US dollar. So this rate, I'm talking about this rate. So the bank is willing to purchase the US dollar at 64 rupees and 3 paisa, and the bank is willing to sell the US dollars for 61 US dollar is equal to 64 rupees and 5 paisa. So let's move on to the spot prices. This is the spot price for January and this is the spot price for February. The bid side on the January. So the bank is willing to buy the US dollar for January on 31st January. On this is the rate for 15th of December. On 15th of December, the spot price was the price on the 15th of December. And the bank was willing to buy US dollars delivery at 64 rupees 22 paisa. How we came at this price? 64.03 plus 19, right? So that's how we came to the January data or January price. So the bank is willing to buy one US dollar for January delivery at rupees 64.22 and they are willing to sell the US dollar at 64 rupees and 26 paisa. 4 paisa is the margin. Since the rate are more expensive than the spot rate, we can conclude that the US dollar is quoted as premium. Are you getting my point? The US dollar is being quoted at a premium while Indian rupees is trading at a discount. This is an important point, students. Thus, the Indian rupee is going to be weaker in future. Thus, forward price, the future expected price by the bank, according to bank, the Indian rupees is going to be weaker in future. That's according to bank. So the Indian rupee is available at discount while the US dollar is available at a premium. So this is an important point. So we are right now the base currency is INR. So that's all for today, students. That's all for the forward markets. So tomorrow I hope I will conduct a lecture on forward market. So the notes for this chapter is also available, and tomorrow I will do a proper lecture on forward markets in India. So I hope you are able to understand this simple lecture. This portion is very, very important. This one is very important. You need to understand this. This is how a bank, you know, provide the spot and the forward rates for the various currencies. So that's all for the today, students. Thank you and have a nice day. Bye.